And we became really good friends. And it's such a privilege.
Hemos podido desarrollar una gran amistad y tengo el privilegio
to have a speak to us Yucumeros and Yucumeras.
De tenerla con nosotros hablando y enseñando a todos nosotros como
Yucumeros. Let's welcome Ruth Padilla de Borst.
A Ruth.
So good to have you here, Ruth.
Es tan bueno tenerte aquí, Ruth.
And I'm going to have Kaya to pray, Kaya Letu from South Africa to pray in Xhosa a short prayer.
Y voy a pedirle a Kaya que pueda orar con una oración bien corta.
Even it sounds good in Spanish, corta.
Corta. Aún en español suena muy bien corta.
Let's pray together.
Oremos juntos.
Khawela maqhawe siyabulela ngobomi buka dadewethu Sister Ruth simzisa phambi kwakho ngalemini sithi ngalemini sikuyo makwenzeke intando yakho sithi lawula phakathi kwethu sithi ubukumkana bakho mabofike msebenzise ke bawo siyabulana ngobomi bakhe ngelika Jesu Christi kama amen
amen. Let's welcome Ruth.
Démosle la bienvenida a Ruth.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Reflexiones sobre misión, poder y reinado de Dios.
This reflection over missions, power in the kingdom of God.
Ir al cielo. Yo querer ir al cielo.
Go to heaven? Would I want to go to heaven?
De ninguna manera.
No way.
Si estos explotadores españoles que han venido a establecer su imperio.
If these Spaniards that exploded everything just wanted to bring their kingdom.
Desterrándonos, esclavizándonos y violando a nuestras mujeres, irán al cielo.
Enslaving us, taking everything from us and raping our women, if they're going to go to heaven.
Yo elijo ir al infierno.
I would rather go to hell.
Palabras de un líder indígena frente a la alianza entre la cruz y la espada. En mano de los conquistadores españoles en estas tierras.
This was the words of an indigenous leader between the cross and a sword with the Spaniards that were conquering.
Palabras que pintan un telón de fondo para nuestra conversación de hoy.
These are the words that paint the background of what we will be talking about today.
En la tierra como en el cielo.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Este es el tema que nos convoca.
This is the thing that brings us together.
¿Y qué es lo que rogamos que ocurra en la tierra como en el cielo?
And what are we asking to happen here on earth just like in heaven?
Hágase tu voluntad.
Your will be done.
¿La voluntad de quién?
Whose will?
Padre nuestro.
Our Father.
Hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Tu voluntad, no la nuestra.
Your will be done here on earth. Not our will, your will here on earth.
Que se cumplan tus propósitos, no los nuestros.
To fulfill his purposes, not our own.
Que la creación toda refleje tus deseos, no los nuestros.
That all of creation would reflect your desires and not our own.
Esa es nuestra oración.
This is our prayer.
Ahora, ¿cuántas veces hemos repetido esa plegaria?
Now, how many times have we repeated this phrase?
¿Y cuánto nos hemos detenido a reflexionar sobre sus implicaciones?
But how many of us have actually taken the time to reflect upon the implications?
Hoy lo haremos.
That's what we're going to do today.
Primero recorreremos a vuelo de pájaro.
First, we're going to take a journey here.
La historia de esta región del mundo que nos acoge hoy.
In the story of this region that we are in today.
Para tomar conciencia de dos posturas y vivencias misioneras contrastantes.
To look at two different postures of missions that are very in contrast with one another.
Una de ellas congruente con el evangelio, la otra no.
One of them that is congruent with the gospel, but the other is not.
Luego nos internaremos en el relato bíblico que encontramos en Isaías 64 y 65.
And then we'll look at the biblical narrative that we find in Isaiah 64 and 65.
Antes de proseguir en típica postura latina, debo darles la bienvenida y compartir saludos.
Before we just continue in the typical way as a Latin, I'd love to just give you the welcome of being here.
Bienvenidos y bienvenidas a la hermosa tierra de Avialla.
You know, welcome each one of you to this beautiful land of Avialla.
La tierra madura, la sangre vital.
The mature land, the holy area, the vital blood.
Que los europeos llamaron América y luego Latina.
And then the Europeans called it America and then Latin.
Aquí nos entremezclamos personas de pueblos originarios.
Here we mix people that come from their own groups.
Herederas de africanas traficadas.
You know, some of the inheritance from the Africans that were actually brought forth and trafficked here.
Descendientes de conquistadores europeos.
Descendants of European conquistadores.
E inmigrantes del mundo entero.
And immigrants from all over the world.
Les traigo también saludos de sus hermanos y hermanas de Casa Adobe.
And so I would bring you the greetings from your brothers and sisters from the Adobe House.
La comunidad cristiana intencional de la cual formamos parte mi esposo Santiago y yo en Santo Domingo de Heredia, Costa Rica, aquí nomás.
This is what they call the intentional Christian community with which they are a part of, her together with her husband in Santo Domingo.
En esta comunidad que incluye una familia refugiada del Salvador, un joven peruano en busca de vocación.
Within this community that includes a family that are refugees from El Salvador and a young man from Peru seeking what is his vocation.
Una pastora luterana con su hijo adolescente.
A Lutheran pastor with her young adolescent.
Y otras personas que vienen y van.
And other people that are just coming and going. Even though the Costa Ricans do not yet suffer all the violence and what's happening as their neighbors up north do.
La violencia, el narcotráfico y el mercado de armas sigue creciendo.
The violence, the drug trafficking, everything continues growing here.
En la región en general, los ingresos más fuertes vienen de las remesas que envían los familiares del norte.
And the highest income still comes from families sending money from outside, from up north.
La mayor exportación son mujeres traficadas para el mercado del sexo.
The greatest export from here are women being trafficked for the sexual trade.
Junto con ellas hacia el norte suben las drogas.
And together with their neighbors up north, they bring up the drugs.
Along with them, towards the north go the drugs. Mm-hmm. Y desde el norte bajan las armas.
And then from the north, they're bringing down the weapons.
Por los llamados tratados de libre comercio.
And for the calling of free commerce or free trade.
Mientras los agricultores estadounidenses reciben subsidios para descartar sus cultivos.
While the American agriculturists are receiving income to stop planting.
Los agricultores centroamericanos no pueden ni vender el maíz porque no pueden competir con el bajo precio del excedente enviado desde el norte.
The locals that are planting can't even afford to plant because of the price of the corn because they cannot compete with what is coming in from the outside.
Mientras los consumidores estadounidenses descartan su ropa para seguir la última moda.
While the people and the consumers of the United States just throw away their clothes to continue with the most modern marks and what they can have with style.
Muchos centroamericanos son esclavizados en fábricas sin leyes laborales que los protejan.
Many Central Americans are trapped within these businesses as slaves with nothing else or no one to set them free.
Mientras que el capital es libre de viajar, invertido y desposeído a voluntad y para el beneficio de los grandes negocios.
While capital is free for the trade and investing and doing anything they want with their will for the greater businesses and the larger businesses.
Solo los ricos con pasaportes y visas del imperio son verdaderamente libres de ir y venir.
It's really just the wealthiest that have this freedom with their passports to be able to come and go.
Los otros millones se mantienen privados de toda esperanza de salir de la pobreza.
All of the poor must stay within their poverty and isolation of not knowing what that is to be able to go out.
Libres solo para ser víctimas de las pandillas.
Free to only be victims of the family.
Morir the gangs.
Of
gangs.
The,
gangs.
Of the guy, oh, of the gangs. Sorry, to be free, only be victims of gangs.
Morir en el desierto.
To die in the desert.
O ser rechazados en el norte.
Or to be rejected from the north.
Como lo fueron hoy mismo cientos de miles de dreamers.
Just like today, hundreds of thousands of the dreamers were rejected.
Es en medio de este cuadro que rogamos a Dios.
It's in the middle of this framework that we are calling out to God.
Tu voluntad sea hecha en la tierra como en el cielo.
Your will be done here on earth just as it is in heaven.
Les invito ahora a recorrer rápidamente la historia de la misión cristiana en América Latina.
So I'd invite you quickly, let's just run through the history of the mission here in Latin America.
Observando los contrastantes rostros de quienes se presentaban como embajadores terrenales de Dios.
And we're going to see the two contrasting ideas of those that were standing up as being the ambassadors of the message of God.
Their contrasting faces. En el camino preguntaremos, ¿qué cuadro del cielo y de la voluntad de Dios pintaron y pintan con su vida estas personas?
And so what we're going to ask is, what image of heaven and the will of God are they painting as they're showing their lives to these people?
Una pista general.
Just a general tip for you, or a
el
clue.
El contraste gira alrededor de la relación entre evangelio y poder.
The contest that is going around the relationship with the gospel and power.
Es que nos guste o no, en toda dimensión de la creación y de la existencia humana hay asuntos de poder.
And whether you like it or not, everything that has to do with the dimensions of the creation of existence, it has to do with power.
Se torna necesaria la pregunta, ¿el testimonio cristiano refleja amor al poder o el poder del amor?
So we have to ask ourselves this question, within the Christian witness, are we reflecting the love of power or the power that comes with love?
The power of love or the love of power. Comenzamos con el contraste entre la misión en nombre del imperio y la misión en nombre del otro Cristo español.
So we're going to start with the contrast between the mission in the name of the imperial and also the mission between what came as the Spaniard conqueror.
Okay, sorry, this is a little technical. The contrast between the God and the mission in the name of empire and the mission in the name of the other Spanish Christ. It's okay.
No, you're good.
Just... ¿Qué cuadro del cielo tendría el nativo de Ayala que citamos al comienzo a partir de su experiencia con los evangelizadores de su día?
So we must ask the question, what image of heaven do the natives of Ayala, when they start with the beginning of their experiences with the guys that were bringing the evangelization of this day?
Si estos conquistadores abusadores van al cielo, yo prefiero ir al infierno.
If these conquistadores come and they're going to heaven, I would prefer to go to hell.
En la pared de la Catedral de Quito, Ecuador.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
Yeah. En la pared de la Catedral de Quito, Ecuador.
So on the wall of the cathedral in Quito, Ecuador.
Dos placas registran los nombres de los fundadores de la ciudad.
Two different places show the founders of the city.
Entre ellos está Juan Padilla.
And within them you have Juan Padilla.
Mi antepasado.
And that's one of my descendants.
Pero no comparto esto con orgullo.
But I do not share this to you with pride.
Porque las iglesias católicas como esa.
Because the Catholic churches like this one.
Se construyeron sobre las ruinas saqueadas de antiguos templos de incas, aztecas y mayas.
They are built over the ruins of the Aztecs and the Mayans and the temples that they once had.
La cristiandad colonial fue erigida sobre el pillaje y el saqueo de la población nativa, también mis antepasados.
The colonial Christianity was actually built over the pillaging and taking over of these native populations who are also my descendants.
Ancestors.
Or ancestors, thank you.
And cristiandad is Christendom.
Christendom, thank you. Mm-hmm.
Los habitantes originales de Ayala recibieron el evangelio cristiano al filo de una espada.
The original inhabitants of Abya Yala, they received the gospel through the sword.
Cuando los conquistadores españoles y portugueses los descubrieron.
When the Spaniard and Portuguese conquistadores discovered them.
A finales del siglo 15.
In the end of the 15th century.
El dios del poder imperial bendijo la conquista militar y la sed de riqueza.
The imperial god of power blessed this military conquer and the desire of wealth.
Trajo consigo lenguas ininteligibles.
And they brought with them languages that were ununderstandable.
Enfermedades intratables y tradiciones culturales extrañas.
You know, sicknesses that were untreatable in cultural traditions that were they were outside of what was here.
Dice John Mackay en su libro El Otro Cristo Español.
John Mackay in his book says The Other Spanish Christian.
The Other Spanish Christ.
Or the Extra Spanish Christ.
Es el título del libro. Dice, quote, los conquistadores tenían pasión por los ritos.
It says the Spanish conquistadores they had a passion for rituals.
Pero su mensaje estaba desprovisto de contenido ético.
But their message was completely disconnected from any content of ethics.
Y sus propias vidas de atractivo y consistencia cristiana.
In an attractive life of any consistency of Christianity.
Podían entonces asistir a misa piadosamente el domingo por la mañana.
So they could go to the godly mass on Sunday morning.
Azotar hasta la muerte a un esclavo por la tarde.
And then go beat a slave even to death in the afternoon.
Y violar a varias mujeres indígenas por la noche.
Rape the indigenous women at night.
Algunas notables excepciones dieron a conocer al Cristo de los evangelios.
Some of the most notable exceptions were able to come and know the Christ of the evangelicals.
They were able to make known the Christ of the Gospels. Sacerdotes católicos como Antonio Montesinos, Bartolomé de las Casas, abogaron públicamente por la vida y la dignidad de los habitantes originales de las Américas.
So some of these Catholic priests like Antonio Montesinos and Bartolomé of the Homes, they were the ones that were speaking out and publicly proclaiming for the life of these indigenous and the dignity of the original people that lived here.
El jesuita Pedro Claver sirvió durante muchos años en la ciudad de Cartagena, Colombia, como el autodenominado esclavo de los esclavos.
And so the Jesuit Pedro Claver, he served for many years in the city in Cartagena, Colombia, and he was the self-proclaimed the slave of the slaves.
Al entregar sus vidas en una pastoral compasiva, servicio desinteresado y la defensa de la dignidad de todas las personas.
And so while giving his life over to compassive pastoral, uninterested service, self-giving love and the defense and the dignity of all people.
Misioneros como estos dieron a conocer al Dios amoroso.
It was missionaries that, like this that made a loving God known.
Que protege a los débiles. La diversidad cultural.
And that would protect the weak and affirm cultural diversity.
No tenemos suficiente tiempo para entrar en detalles.
We do not have enough time to get into all the details here.
Pero en este contraste entre quienes distorsionan el evangelio para sus propios intereses.
But within this contrast are the ones that distorted the gospel for their own interests.
Y para quienes encarnan las buenas noticias de la buena creación y salvación de Dios.
And the ones that incarnate brought upon themselves the good news and the salvation of God.
The good news of good creation and salvation. Prosigue ese contraste hasta el día de hoy.
And we continue that contrast up until the day of today.
En el siglo XIX, el contraste se marcó entre quienes asociaron la misión con la expansión comercial de las naciones protestantes europeas.
And we can see in the 19th century, the contrast continued forward between those that continued the mission connected with the expansion of commerce and the Protestant European nations.
Aun cuando la búsqueda de esos intereses fomentaba el racismo, la explotación de los pueblos indígenas y la trata de esclavos.
Even when the seeking of these interests were bringing forth great racism, exploiting the local indigenous people in slave trade.
Eso es por un lado. Y por el otro, quienes se entregaron sacrificialmente al estilo de Jesús en la arena pública.
This is what we see on one side, but then we see on the other side those who gave themselves sacrificially in the lifestyle of Jesus in the public arena.
Promoviendo el acceso a la Biblia y a la educación.
Promoting access to the Bible and education.
Por parte de los sectores relegados de la población.
Based on the different sectors within the population.
Bringing Bible and education to those sectors. Hay historias fascinantes de piratas británicos.
And there's some very fascinating story of British pirates.
Que leían la Biblia y rezaban.
That would then read the Bible and pray.
Antes de saquear a los barcos españoles y pagar cuotas a los países de reciente formación.
Before they would take over these other ships and boats and take everything that they had.
En contraste, el misionero inglés Alan Gardiner trabajó entre las poblaciones indígenas.
In contrast, the English missionary Alan Gardiner worked together within the indigenous populations.
El escocés James Diego Thompson distribuyó Biblias.
In James Diego Thompson, he was the one that gave out Bibles.
Comenzó una escuela de formación de profesores en Perú.
And he started a school of building up teachers in Peru.
Abrió escuelas en las áreas más pobres para niños indígenas y negros.
And he opened schools for the poorest kids, the indigenous and black.
Y abogó por la educación de las mujeres.
And he would appeal for the education of women.
Diciendo, y cito, la educación femenina, en mi opinión, es la cosa más deseada en todo el país.
And what he would say, and this is a quote of him, feminine education, in my opinion, is the thing that we most desire in my country.
In every country. Y cuando sea debidamente atendida, la renovación del mundo continuará rápidamente.
And when we can actually do this and make it happen, then the renovation of the entire world will be very quickly.
Go Diego Thompson. Junto con Francisco Pensotti, el primer gran promotor latinoamericano del protestantismo.
And this together with Francisco Pensotti, and he was the great promoter in Latin America of Protestantism.
Thompson introdujo el Nuevo Testamento como libro de texto en las escuelas.
He introduced the New Testament as the book within schools to be used by.
También tradujo el Nuevo Testamento al idioma quechua.
And he also translated the New Testament into the Quechua language.
¿Hay gente Quechua aquí?
Is there anyone from that speaks Quechua here?
Bueno. Para esta traducción colaboró con sacerdotes católicos romanos, quienes también ayudaron a distribuir Biblias.
With this translation, he collaborated with Roman Catholic priests that then worked together with him in order to help and distribute the Bibles as well.
Este modelo ecuménico e integral de misión abrió un camino para generaciones futuras.
This ecumenic model that was holistic also worked to help the mission open to other future generations.
A inicios del siglo XX, intelectuales y activistas cristianos latinoamericanos como Erasmo Braga y Báez Camargo, misioneros como John Mackay, William Morris, contribuyeron a la educación pública.
In the beginning of the next century, intellectuals and Christian activists throughout Latin America, just like Erasmo Braga, Báez Camargo, and missionaries like John Mackay and William Morris, they contributed to the public education in the forming of public policies for the common good based on Christian conviction.
Mediante la educación y el nuevo acceso a las escrituras,
and through the education with new access to the scriptures,
sectores oprimidos como esclavos africanos, esclavos liberados y pueblos indígenas.
The ones that were most oppressed, like African slaves, they were set free. Indigenous people received the message of Protestantism within them with a calling to faith and the hope to fight for their own freedom.
Y ahí se me adelantó. Ellos recibieron el mensaje protestante como un llamado a la fe y a la esperanza en su lucha por la libertad. En el siglo XX, con la ascendencia de Estados Unidos en la geopolítica mundial.
In the 20th century, as the United States ascended into the geopolitical world,
y en medio de guerras mundiales, la Guerra Fría, dictaduras militares, revoluciones y creciente explotación.
In the middle of these world wars, the Cold War, military dictators, revolution, and the growing exploitation,
América Latina continuó sintiendo el impacto del trabajo misionero extranjero.
Latin America continued feeling the impact of the foreign missionary coming in.
Pero el origen de los misioneros y el financiamiento para la vida y el trabajo de la iglesia tomó un matiz más evangélico y norteamericano y menos protestante y europeo.
But the origin then of these missionaries, both financially and their lifestyle, took the work both within the church and the gospel that was brought in from North America, which was like a Protestantism bit from Europe.
So it became more evangelical and North American than Protestant and European. El contraste ahora era entre quienes asociaron la expansión del evangelio con los métodos y valores del capitalismo global.
So the contrast then we see becomes associated with the expansion of the gospel through methodology and values of global capitalism.
Por un lado,
on one side.
Y quienes se atrevieron a cuestionar el sistema.
And the ones that would then dare to question the system.
Y a denunciar en nombre de Jesucristo la exclusión que esta generaba.
And to denounce the name of Jesus Christ and the exclusion that this was generating.
Por un lado, a medida que la población evangélica y pentecostal crecía en la región.
So on one side, while the population and the growth within the evangelical and Pentecostal was growing within the region.
Y particularmente en Centroamérica.
And specifically in Central America.
Muchas iglesias se encandilaron con las brillantes luces de neón del consumismo.
A lot of these churches grabbed on to the wonderful lights of consumerism.
Y la ilusión de que lo más grande es siempre mejor.
And this illusion that what is biggest is what is best.
Con un espíritu triunfalista, muchos entraron en la carrera por el templo más grande.
So with this triumphant spirit, many fought forward to have the biggest temple.
La radio de mayor alcance.
You know, the radio station that could reach the most.
El número récord de miembros.
You know, the record number of people.
Muchos se entremezclaron con las élites gobernantes.
Many started to mix in with the most elite of the government.
Y establecieron relaciones comerciales que favorecerían los intereses de los evangélicos.
And they started to establish these commercial relationships that were in favor now of the evangelicals.
Los apóstoles contemporáneos.
And the contemporary apostles.
Comenzaron a usar, a conducir y a exudar los símbolos del éxito.
They started to use, they started to drive, and they started to use all the symbols of success.
El crecimiento masivo, la lealtad hacia los líderes estatales y financieros.
The massive growth, the loyalty towards state and financial leaders.
Y el impacto de las imágenes positivas eliminaron toda necesidad de sufrimiento.
And the impact of positive imagery took away all need of suffering.
En la mente de muchos, los días de ser perseguidos y excluidos por la fe habían sido sepultados en el pasado.
In the mind of many, the days of being persecuted and pushed aside because of your faith were completely behind us now.
Cuando los evangélicos eran una minoría que no tenía voz.
When the evangelicals were just a minority that had no voice.
En marcado contraste con estas expresiones religiosas, surgieron dos movimientos paralelos de discipulado radical.
In a contrasting market within these two different religious expressions, rose up two movements of what it meant to have radical discipleship.
Las comunidades de base de la Iglesia Católica Romana y el movimiento de misión integral entre los evangélicos radicales.
And it was the communities based within the Roman Catholic Church and the movement of holistic mission among radical evangelicals.
Más conocidos mundialmente son las teologías de la liberación.
You know, something that is more commonly known as liberation theology.
Cuando el Vaticano II catalizó la renovación de la Iglesia Católica.
When the Second Vatican was able to take back the power within the Catholic Church.
brought renewal in the Catholic Church. Millones de personas que nunca habían tenido acceso a la escritura compraron Biblias en su idioma.
Then millions of the people that had never had access to scripture were able to finally buy Bibles within their own language.
La palabra de Dios llegó al pueblo de Dios.
The people of God, or the word of God, came to the people of God.
Y en ciudades, aldeas y lugares rurales, mujeres y hombres comenzaron a reunirse en círculos de estudio bíblico y oración.
In city and village, in the most remote places, men, women, kids, they would come together to study the Bible.
Y así comenzaron las comunidades de base.
And that was how the communities of base came forward.
Reuniones de creyentes que exploraron la Biblia a la luz de su contexto.
The meetings of these believers that would look at the Bible in the light of its context, where they are.
Y su contexto a la luz de la Escritura.
And they would look in the context in the light of the scriptures that they had.
Menos conocido es el movimiento de misión integral.
What is less known within this movement is the holistic mission.
Less known is the movement of holistic mission. Que comenzó en medio de evangélicos radicales.
That started in the middle of radical evangelicals.
En un esfuerzo intencionado por responder desde el evangelio y con sólidas bases bíblicas a las realidades del contexto injusto, pobre y revolucionario de América Latina.
And it was an intended effort to respond from the gospel with a solid biblical basis to the realities within this unjust context. In the revolution within Latin America for the transformation of these realities that they were facing.
La misión integral entonces es una articulación y práctica teológica misiológica.
So the holistic mission is an articulation of both the practical theological and missionological.
Que anima a los seguidores de Jesús a vincular todo el evangelio.
That would encourage the followers of Jesus to come together with the entire gospel.
A toda la vida.
With your entire life.
Bajo el señorío de Cristo en la fuerza del Espíritu Santo.
Below the lordship of Jesus Christ in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Para que el reino de Dios y su justicia se hagan visibles en contextos históricos particulares.
So that the kingdom of God could be visible within in the justice that is being done within these historical particular contexts.
Las posturas contrastantes con respecto al poder también se evidencian en el movimiento pentecostal y neopentecostal.
These two contrasting postures is also seen with power in the evidence of the Pentecostal movement and the neo-Pentecostal movement.
Que ha crecido exponencialmente en América Latina y ha impactado todas las denominaciones.
And this has just grown exponentially throughout Latin America, but also impacted many other denominations.
Muchas iglesias pentecostales y neopentecostales promueven hoy una teología de prosperidad.
Many of the Pentecostal and neo-Pentecostal theologies promote the gospel of prosperity.
Y demuestran edificios ostentosos.
In these huge buildings.
Débiles procesos de rendición de cuentas.
Very weak process of accountability.
Y una obvia búsqueda de ascendencia política y los privilegios vinculados al mismo.
And an obvious seeking of getting special privileges and ascending in both political and economic.
Por el contrario, pastores y congregaciones pentecostales se han trasladado a algunos de los lugares más violentos.
On the contrast, you have these Pentecostal pastors and churches that have gone to the most violent, difficult situations.
Se han acercado a pandilleros.
They have drawn close to gang members.
Les han abierto oportunidades laborales para que logren salir de su submundo de muerte.
And they've given them opportunities to get a job and come out of this world of death.
Como lo hizo Jesucristo, están arriesgando sus vidas.
Just like Jesus Christ did, coming in close to their lives.
He's risking their lives y haciendo tangible el amor de Dios.
And making the love of God tangible.
Mediante su abrazo a los rechazados de la sociedad.
While he would embrace the ones that had been rejected by society.
Preguntábamos al comienzo de nuestra caminata por las tierras de Abiyala.
And so we asked ourselves at the beginning of this walk through the lands of Abiyala.
¿Qué cuadro del cielo y de la voluntad de Dios pintaron y pintan con sus vidas en la tierra estas personas?
What image of heaven and God's will did these men and women paint using their lives on earth for these people?
Ahora preguntamos, ¿será que podemos acceder a un cuadro que haya pintado Dios mismo, que nos muestre cómo es su voluntad en el cielo?
I must ask, are we able to actually access the image that God himself paints of what heaven is like, or what earth will be like in heaven?
¿Existirá tal cuadro?
Does that image exist?
Por gracia de Dios, la respuesta es sí.
By the grace of God, we can say yes.
En vívidos pincelazos, la escritura toda retrata la voluntad del Creador. With vivid brush strokes,
the scriptures are able to give back what is the will of our Creator.
It paints the picture of our Creator's will. Como así también las consecuencias para la creación entera cuando sus criaturas viven o no según esa voluntad.
And it also shows us the consequences of his creation on whether they are according or whether they walk against his will.
Es que el cielo, en el lenguaje bíblico, dista mucho de las caricaturas creadas por la imaginación humana.
It's because heaven, in biblical language, is really seen a lot through the characteristics of just human imagination.
It's very different
from what human imagination is.
From the caricatures created by human imagination. El cielo no es ni más ni menos que el lugar en el cual habita plenamente Dios.
So heaven is nothing more or nothing less than where God simply completely abides.
Donde vive Dios, la comunidad de amor.
Where God lives, this community of love.
El ámbito marcado por su carácter.
The realm that is inhabited by his character.
Marked by his character, en el cual se cumple su voluntad sin contraposición.
Where his will is fulfilled without any oppression coming against.
Y se lo reconoce como soberano.
And he is acknowledged as sovereign.
¿Cómo se verá eso en la tierra, en medio de las ambigüedades y dolencias de la experiencia humana?
How does that look on earth in the middle of all the ambiguities, the pains, human experiences?
Y de una creación que gime bajo el abuso de la ilimitada codicia humana.
In a creation that is calling out before the abuse of the unlimited human coveting.
Groaning. En estos días explorarán cómo Dios se hace presente, acampa, habita en medio de su creación.
So through these next few days we are going to explore how God is made present, how he stays with us, what it means to be in his creation.
Hoy vamos a adentrarnos en el cuadro que presenta la escritura que conocemos como Isaías 65.
So today we're going to jump into and look at the image that scripture paints according to Isaiah 65, 17 through 25.
Versos 17 a 25. Los receptores de este texto son sufridos exilados que hace poco regresaron a su tierra.
So there was ones that received this text were the suffering exiles that having been taken back just recently from their land.
Después de años de cautividad en Babilonia.
And they were returning after years of captivity in Babylon.
Sus altas expectativas respecto a su regreso se han derrumbado.
And their high expectations of returning had been lost.
La tierra demora en ofrecer fruto.
The land itself had stopped offering fruit.
It takes a long time for it to yield fruit. Los gobernantes se hacen los sordos.
And the rulers, you know, made themselves deaf.
Los autoestablecidos líderes religiosos solo se sirven a sí mismos.
And the self-established religious leaders only serve themselves.
La opresión es más mordaz cuando es impuesta por compatriotas.
And the oppression is even more morbid when it is imposed upon us by our counter-patriots.
Tienden mesas para ídolos paganos mientras los pobres sufren hambre.
They had huge tables for their idols while the poor would suffer of hunger.
Las prácticas paganas ahuyentan cualquier pensamiento sobre el Dios de sus antepasados.
And the pagan practices had pushed away every thought and memory of their God, of their
ancestors. Su propia tierra se ve afectada.
Their own land had been affected.
Ahora es un valle de Acor, un lugar de muerte.
Now it was a valley of Acre, a place of death.
Desde la desolación, algunos claman a Dios, como registra Isaías 64:1.
And from their despair, some of them called out to God, as we see in Isaiah 64.
Ojalá rasgaras los cielos y descendieras.
As if the heavens, I pray that they would just open and come down.
That you would come down from the heavens. La respuesta de Dios no tarda en llegar.
And God's response did not take long.
Dios ve.
God sees.
Se aflige por la situación y promete restauración y renovación.
He is afflicted by the situation and he promises restoration and renovation.
Este no es un simple remiendo, un parche.
This is not just a simple patch or a covering or a band-aid.
Un ensamblaje de las piezas que hay a mano.
Just kind of putting some of the pieces back together with the hands that were assembled.
La visión del profeta.
The vision of the prophet here.
Continúa con una descripción sorprendente de recreación absoluta.
Continues with an incredible description of absolute recreation.
Una transformación que no deja nada sin afectar.
A transformation that would leave nothing that was unaffected.
El Dios que en un principio creó el cielo y la tierra.
The God who in the beginning created the heavens and the earth.
Muestra su voluntad, su deseo para esa creación.
He shows his will and his desire for this creation.
Afirma, presten atención, que estoy por crear un cielo nuevo y una tierra nueva.
And he then affirms, pay attention, I am about to create a new heaven and a new earth.
No volverán a mencionarse las cosas pasadas ni se traerán a la memoria.
You will not again mention the things of the past or no longer remember them.
El Dios que en el principio creó todas las cosas.
The God who in the beginning created all things.
Y que como mencionamos esta mañana, al ver, celebró su bondad.
And like we had mentioned this morning, in seeing it,
He celebrated
his goodness.
Its goodness. Exclama, alégrense más bien y regocíjense por siempre por lo que estoy a punto de crear. Verso 18.
This is verse 14.
18.
Verse 18. He called out and said, rejoice, rejoice forever, because this is what I'm about to create.
Estoy por crear una Jerusalén feliz, un pueblo lleno de alegría.
I am about to create a happy Jerusalem, a people full of joy.
Me regocijaré por Jerusalén y me alegraré en mi pueblo.
And I will rejoice in Jerusalem and I will find joy in my people.
Quiero regocijarme otra vez, como lo hice en el principio, dice el creador y sustentador de toda la vida.
And I want to rejoice again over them like I did in the very beginning, says the one who created everything from the beginning, the one who sustains all life.
Vengan ahora, acompáñenme, les mostraré por qué.
Come now, walk with me, I will show you why.
En la visión esperanzadora que el profeta le ofrece al pueblo de Israel.
And in this great hopeful vision that the prophet gives for the people of Israel.
Las relaciones destrozadas por el pecado.
In the relationships that had been destroyed and broken because of sin.
Son remendadas por la mano recreadora de Dios.
They are fixed and remended by the healing hand of God.
Por gracia divina, Dios, su pueblo y su tierra nuevamente se van entretejiendo con relaciones justas.
By God's grace, him, his people, and the land once again are woven back together with just relationships.
Que transforman radicalmente el panorama social, económico y ecológico.
That would radically transform the social, economic, and ecological perspective.
Ahora un momento para ustedes.
Now this
ahí
is a moment
están,
for you guys,
en sus
here
mesas,
where you are.
Tómense tiempo para leer detenidamente los versos 20 a 25.
Take some moments to read very carefully Isaiah 50, 20 through 25.
Isaiah 65. Yep, sorry. Mi error. No es 15, sino 65. Isaías 65. Isaiah 65, verses Perdón.
No, más bien. Excellent. Sorry, mistake. It's Isaiah 65, not 15. Isaiah 65, verses 20 through 25. Take a moment to read this.
Observen los nunca más que marcan el cielo nuevo y la tierra nueva. Nunca más.
And so observe closely where it says, I will never again. I will never again.
Never again.
And it marks the new heaven and the new earth.
Okay, entonces miran el pasaje.
So look at the passage.
Concéntrense en los nunca más.
Focus on the never agains.
Y luego conversen sobre las realidades de sus contextos ministeriales.
And then converse together, have a talk about the reality of your ministry context.
En algunos de esos nunca más.
Where it talks about this never again.
¿Cómo se verá ese nunca más en sus contextos particulares?
How would this never again look in your particular context?
Tienen 5 minutos.
You have 5 minutes.
Bueno, el peor papel que me han dado es ser la interruptora.
So the role that they have given me is to be the one that interrupts you.
It's the worst role.
It's the worst role to have.
Pero vamos a continuar juntos.
But we're going to continue together.
Y voy a enseñarles primero una técnica muy útil.
And I'm going to first show you a very useful technique.
¿Se fijaron cuando está todo el mundo hablando y la persona del frente quiere hablar?
You know when like someone's talking, the person up front like wants to talk?
Y empieza a hablar más fuerte.
And they start to speak louder and louder.
Entonces la gente alrededor de las mesas habla más fuerte.
So the people around the table speak louder and louder.
Y entonces se expande el ruido.
And then the noise just gets expanded.
Una opción es esta.
An option is this.
La persona que necesita hablar levanta la mano.
The person that needs to speak raises their hand.
Y cada persona que ve esa mano levantada levanta la mano.
And then everyone that sees that hand raised raises their hand.
Y se tapa la boca.
And covers their mouth.
Entonces, en lugar de expandir ruido,
so rather than expanding more noise,
expandimos silencio.
We actually get into silence.
Nunca más.
No longer.
Nunca más habrá en ella niños que vivan pocos días.
No longer will there be in it an infant who lives but a few days.
Nunca más mortalidad infantil debido a enfermedades fácilmente prevenidas y aguas contaminadas.
No more infant deaths that could be prevented by contaminated waters or sicknesses within them.
Ni ancianos que no completen sus años.
Or old men who do not fulfill their days.
Nunca más la muerte prematura ni el abandono y desamparo de los ancianos a una vida sin dignidad.
Never again premature death or people that are abandoned or put out or the ones that go through life without dignity.
Como piezas obsoletas de la maquinaria productiva.
As just pieces of the productive machinery that
old
have been used.
Old people as if treated as if they were obsolete pieces of the productive machinery. Nunca más construirán casas para que otros las habiten.
No longer will they build homes that another will live in.
Nunca más la expropiación abusiva.
Never again abusive expropriation.
Ni familias enteras asentadas precariamente hoy y desalojadas mañana.
Or families that are sitting down fine today and then pushed away tomorrow.
Ni gente sin techo deambulando por las calles.
And people without a roof over their head and begging in the streets.
Muriendo en desiertos o ahogándose en mares.
Begging in the deserts or dying in the deserts or drowning in the oceans.
Nunca más plantarán viñas para que otros coman.
No longer will they plant vineyards for others to eat.
Mis escogidos disfrutarán de la obra de sus manos.
My chosen will enjoy the work of their hands.
Nunca más trabajará la gente para alimentar a otros mientras ellos padecen hambre.
No longer will they work to feed others while they themselves die of hunger.
Ni se fatigarán para que los hijos ajenos vivan como reyes.
Or that they would work so that these kids that are not their own would be living like kings.
Nunca más será administrada la tierra por industrias agrícolas que convierten el suelo en un objeto de consumo.
No longer will these administrators take charge of the land with agricultural industries converting what is in the soil as just a consumption of product.
Y en las granjas locales en antigüedades para satisfacer la codicia de los pocos.
In the local farms of the old times to be able to satisfy the greed. To satisfy the greed of the few.
No trabajarán en vano ni tendrán hijos para la desgracia.
They will not work in vain anymore, and they will not have their children through disgrace.
Nunca más se verá gente forzada a trabajar por una limosna.
No longer will people be forced to work just for a simple offering.
Ni en la esclavitud ni criarán a sus hijos sin esperanza para el futuro.
No longer in slavery or raising their kids without hope for a better future.
El lobo y el cordero pasarán juntos. El león comerá paja como el buey. En todo mi monte santo no habrá quien haga daño ni destruya.
The wolf and the lamb will graze together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox, and the dust will be the serpent's food.
In my holy mount.
And they will do no evil or harm in my holy mountain, says the Lord.
Nunca más la intervención humana exterminará especies completas en detrimento de la biodiversidad que sostiene la vida del ecosistema entero.
And no longer will human intervention exterminate complete species in biodiversities that sustains the entire economic system of life.
Ecosystem. Frente a este cuadro social, económico y ecológico tan ideal, lógicamente nos nacen preguntas.
Within this ideal image of social, economic, and ecological.
Ideal, we have many questions. ¿Qué de nuestro mundo quebrantado por guerras y rumores de guerra?
But what about our broken world through wars and rumors of war?
Violentos nacionalismos racistas.
Violent racist nationalisms.
Huracanes e inundaciones.
Hurricanes and floodings.
Consumo irrefrenable y calentamiento global.
Unstoppable consumerism and global heating, global warming.
¿Hay esperanza de un nuevo cielo y una nueva tierra dentro de la historia? Sobre este planeta que sirve de hogar a la humanidad.
Is there hope for a new heaven and a new earth within our history over this planet that serves as home for all of humanity?
¿No serán solo utopías irrealizables?
Is this like an unattainable utopia?
¿O promesas de algún futuro distante en un reino celestial al cual solo podemos esperar pacientemente mientras soportamos las cargas de este mundo?
Or future promises that are just far off in a heavenly kingdom with which we can only wait, praying, patiently waiting for these burdens of the world to be lifted away?
Hasta que Dios lo destruya todo por completo y comience de nuevo desde cero.
Until God will just destroy everything and start over again with nothing from zero.
Es obvio que el récord de los logros humanos no nos conduce más que a este callejón sin salida.
It is obvious that our history of human achievement brings us nowhere other than to this dead end, and we have no exit.
La pobreza, la injusticia, la degradación ecológica y la extinción gradual de muchas formas de vida.
Poverty, injustice, ecological degradation, and the gradual extinction
of so many forms of life. Todos denuncian que el mito del progreso humano no es más que eso.
And every one of these things around us denounce this fact that it is not just a myth, but human progress is no more than this.
That human progress is no more than a myth. Una ilusión positivista y arrogante, sin fundamento alguno en la realidad.
Just a positive and arrogant illusion without foundation in reality.
¿Dónde clamamos? Está la clave para la plenitud abundante que describe Isaías.
So then where do we call out is the key for the abundant fullness that is described here in Isaiah.
¿Será posible que se haga la voluntad de Dios en la tierra como en el cielo?
Would it be possible for God's will to be done here on earth just as it is in heaven?
En su inspirador comentario sobre Colosenses.
In his most inspiring commentary over Colossians.
Son Walsh y Kismet afirman.
They together, Walsh and Kismet affirm the following.
El shalom, la plenitud, el bienestar de todas nuestras relaciones sociales, ecológicas, políticas, agrícolas y económicas radica en una relación restaurada con Dios.
So the shalom, or the fullness, the well-being of all of our social relationships, ecological, political, agrícola, and economic, reside within God's restored relationship.
A restored relationship with God. ¿Puede existir tal plenitud, tal shalom, a lo largo y a lo ancho de la creación, solo si Dios entra a nuestra realidad signada por el conflicto?
This fullness can exist, this shalom, throughout the width and the depth of creation, only if God comes into our reality in the middle of this conflict.
Nuestra realidad tergiversada, opresora y quebrantada con iniciativas de gracia.
That has been broken and oppressed and only through his initiatives of grace coming into this can it be restored.
La buena noticia del Evangelio es que Dios nunca ha dejado de entrar en la realidad humana.
But the good news of the gospel is God has never stopped coming into human reality.
Nunca ha abandonado a su creación.
He has never abandoned his creation.
Nunca ha renunciado al derecho amoroso y sacrificado que ejerce sobre ella.
He has never stopped this loving sacrificial right that he gives over us.
Desde el principio y aún hoy,
from the beginning and even today,
la comunidad de amor, Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo, está activamente sosteniendo todo el universo.
This community of love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, are actively sustaining everything here within this universe.
Y supremamente en Jesucristo, Dios en forma humana, el cielo y la tierra se unen.
Y supremely within Jesus Christ, God in human form, heaven here on earth are united.
En Cristo, el Dios comunidad ha llegado a la tierra.
In Christ, the God and community has come to earth.
Ya ha sido quebrantada por su quebranto.
It has been broken for what he was broken for.
By its brokenness.
By its brokenness.
Ya se ha levantado triunfante.
And he will rise up triumphant.
He has risen up triumphant. Y ya reina hoy soberana y amorosamente.
And he rules today sovereignly and lovingly.
A través de Jesús, Emmanuel, Dios con nosotros.
And through Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us.
El trino Dios asumió el dolor y las limitaciones de la existencia humana.
The triune God took on this pain and the limitations of human existence.
De esta creación desgarrada por el pacto. Por el pecado.
Of this creation has just been torn apart by sin.
De manera de restaurar las relaciones y traer la reconciliación bajo su reinado amoroso.
In a way to restore relationships and bring everything back under his loving reign.
El buen reinado de Dios, donde prevalece la justicia, ya ha sido inaugurado, como conversábamos esta mañana con David.
And the good rule of God has been established with his justice, just like we talked about this morning with David.
Al hacer su morada, su vivienda, con nosotros y nosotras.
In making his dwelling in his abiding here with us.
Dios abre la puerta para que la tierra vuelva a ser nuestro hogar.
God opens the door that the earth can again become our home.
Ya no necesitamos deambular sin hogar ni tierra.
We don't need to wander anymore without home here on earth.
alienados y enemistados los unos contra los otros y con la tierra que nos alimenta.
Alienated, at edge with each other, with those of us that are here on earth.
Or with the earth that feeds us. Ni estamos signados simplemente a aguantar hasta que este mundo pase.
Nor do we have to just simply deal with everything until this world goes by.
Put up with it. Just put up with it. That's not all that we're called to be. Podemos experimentar y dar a conocer la buena voluntad de Dios aquí, ahora, en la tierra, como en el cielo.
Then we can experience and make known the good will of God here, now, on earth, just like it is in heaven.
Vivamos entonces en el poder del amor.
Let's live then in the power of love.
No nos desviemos de la voluntad de Dios por amor al poder.
Let us not stray from the power of love.
From God's will.
God's will for the love of power.
Yeah, may the love of power not lead us to stray from God's will. Vivamos en el ya del reino de Dios.
Let's live in the ya of the kingdom of God.
In the already of the kingdom of God, with con gozosa expectativa.
With joyful expectation.
De su llegada plena, cuando toda rodilla se doble y toda lengua confiese que Jesucristo es el dueño y señor de toda la tierra.
Of his complete return, when every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord of all of life.
Vivamos entre tanto.
And now let's live meanwhile.
Como parte de la nueva humanidad gestada por gracia de Dios.
As a part of the new humanity gestured out by the grace of God.
Born by God's grace, enviada como lo fue Jesús al mundo.
Sent out just like Jesus to the world.
E inspirada a diario por el Espíritu de vida.
And inspired every day by the Spirit of life.
Para que se haga la voluntad de Dios.
So that God's will can be done.
En la tierra,
on
como
earth,
en el cielo.
Just like in heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
Huh? Okay.
Wasn't that wonderful?
¿No fue maravilloso?
Hola.
Do you have hope this afternoon? On earth as it is in heaven.
Pueden decir esto que es hecho en el cielo, como en la tierra como en el cielo.
God has not abandoned us.
El Señor no nos ha abandonado.
He is Emmanuel.
Él es Emmanuel.
He is God with us.
Él es Dios con nosotros.
I'm from Africa. You just have to say amen or look as if you're alive.
Soy de África. Tiene que decir amén.
Yes, God is with us. He hasn't abandoned us.
Dios está con nosotros y no nos ha abandonado.
Wow. Thank you so much, Ruth. We really appreciate what you brought to us this afternoon.
Muchas gracias, Ruth. Apreciamos mucho lo que has traído a nosotros esta tarde.
Tonight we will be recording a session with Ruth that we will be showing later on in this week.
Esta noche vamos a estar grabando a Ruth y vamos a mostrar un poco más tarde en la semana.
It's going to be at 7:30 and you are welcome to join us.
Va a ser a las 7:30 y son bienvenidos para acompañarnos.
But just to let you know, tonight you are free, but you can choose in your freedom if you want to come and listen to Ruth live.
Les queremos recordar que esta noche tienen la noche libre, pero si ustedes así lo desean, pueden acompañarnos a la
So we're going to have a group of leaders here tonight that's going to be with us.
Y vamos a tener un grupo de líderes que nos van a acompañar en esta noche.
And if you would like to join, you are welcome.
Si nos quieren acompañar, son muy bienvenidos.
Ruth, unfortunately, she has to leave us. And she won't be with us.
Desgraciadamente, Ruth tiene que irse y no nos va a poder acompañar.
And so we just want to thank you, Ruth, again for such a wonderful message to us as a family, as a YWAM community.
Y queremos una vez más agradecerte por este maravilloso mensaje que has traído a nosotros como familia de Hukum.
And we pray that this will not be the last time that you will interface with us as a mission.
Me temo que esta no va a ser la última vez que tú vas a estar con nosotros en la misión.
So we've got a small gift that we want to send with you on your journey.
Y tenemos este presente que te queremos dar para que te acompañe en tu jornada.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you all for receiving me. It's a joy really to witness the enthusiasm, the passion for God.
Muchas gracias por recibirme, por compartir conmigo el entusiasmo por el Señor.
Y la búsqueda, no, English. and the willingness to continue learning.
Y el deseo de continuar aprendiendo.
Because we're all on this journey together.
Porque todos estamos en este camino juntos.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ruth.